Hi, I'm Michael Correa, and this is Psych Exam Review. And in this video, I'd like to talk about operational definitions and construct validity. And I'm going to start with a property. So what is a property? Well, a property is a general sort of concept that we want to investigate. So researchers might want to know about the property of happiness, or they might want to know about depression, or intelligence. And an important thing about properties is that we can't directly detect them. So I don't have a happiness detector that's going to tell me exactly how happy you are. So instead, I need to have a way of defining it. And this is my operational definition. So an operational definition is the particular way that I'm going to measure the property. And it's important to remember that it's not actually the property. It's just a representation of the property. It gives us a way to talk about it. So, for instance, if I wanted to know about the length of a desk, you could tell me that the desk is 80 centimeters. And now, this is not saying that 80 centimeters on a tape measure is the desk, but it's a useful representation that helps me determine whether the desk is going to fit in a particular space. And there's other operational definitions that you could use to talk about the length of the desk. You could tell me that it's 0.00049707 miles. And that might be just as accurate as telling me it's 80 centimeters, but in this particular situation, it's not that useful. So different operational definitions are going to be more appropriate in certain situations. In contrast, if I wanted to know the distance between Austin and Houston, I'd probably prefer that you tell me in miles, because I'm not used to thinking about how many centimeters per hour my car can travel. So if I want to figure out how long this trip is going to take, centimeters isn't very useful. Now, we have experience using certain operational definitions. Like for length, we're used to using centimeters or inches or miles, and so we have a pretty good idea of what that means. But when it comes to psychological variables, it can be a little bit more complicated. So let's say we want to know about happiness. So how am I going to define happiness? I can't detect it directly, so I need to come up with an operational definition, something that I can actually measure, and that's going to represent happiness. So you might say, well, okay, I could ask people on a survey, I could say, how happy are you from -5 to +5? That will give me a measurement, but it might be kind of hard to determine what that means. What is +3? That's not as comfortable to me as using centimeters or miles. I don't really know what +3 happiness means. I say, okay, well, I might measure smiling behavior. I say, okay, people smile when they're happy. If people are happy, they tend to smile. So I'm going to say that I'm going to count how much people smile and use that to determine how happy they are. That might be a way of defining happiness. Or you might say, well, smiling is too easy to fake. I want to use laughing. So I'm going to show people a video, I'm going to count how many times they laugh, and I'm going to use that to determine how happy the video made them. Or you might say, well, there might be some brain activity associated with happiness. I'm going to measure people's brain activity in a scanner, and if they show this certain pattern of activity, I'm going to use that to represent their happiness. Okay. What we're hoping for with any of these operational definitions is we want to have construct validity. And what construct validity refers to is the idea that we have the property and we want to see a clear relationship between the property and the operational definition that we've chosen. So I'm going to look at, okay, happiness and smiling. Is there a clear relationship between these two? And we hope that there is. We hope that the property is actually related to the thing that we're measuring. So let's use that example. Let's say, okay, I want to know about happiness, and I'm going to measure smiling behavior, and we're going to ask, is there a clear relationship between these two things? You say, yeah, okay, people smile when they're happy. When people are unhappy, they tend not to smile so much. Okay, this seems like it has construct validity. There seems to be a clear relationship between this property and this definition. It's not perfect. Certainly, people can be happy and not smile, and people can be smiling even though they're not actually happy. So it's not perfect, but we can say it has construct validity. It seems to have a clear relationship between these two things. In contrast, I might say, all right, I want to know about happiness. And let's see, I was really happy when I got my car. So I think cars make people happy. So I'm going to count how many cars people have. And I'm going to use that to determine how happy they are. People have more cars, they're probably happier. People have fewer cars, not so happy. Now in this case, you might look at this relationship and say, you know, I'm not so convinced here. I don't think there's a clear relationship between happiness and the number of cars that somebody owns. There might be some relationship, but it's not a very clear one. And I can certainly imagine lots of people who don't have any cars who, you know, bike everywhere and they seem perfectly happy. And I can imagine somebody who has dozens of cars but isn't actually happy. So in this case, you may say, all right, I'm not convinced. I don't think we have construct validity here. I think our operational definition is not a good representation of our property. And now, this is where we see that operational definitions and construct validity are extremely important, because if this relationship isn't clear, then my conclusions don't really matter. If I told you my study was on happiness, and I found, you know, some conclusion about happiness, and then you looked at my paper and said, wait a minute, you defined happiness as the number of cars that people had, you would immediately disregard my results. They wouldn't matter, because you'd say they're not really about happiness. So this is why it's so important. A faulty operational definition with low construct validity causes us to basically disregard any of the results from that study. And this is why this should be the first thing that you look at whenever you see a study or you see some results. You say, wait a minute, what's the property and how are they measuring it? And if that relationship isn't clear, then I don't really care what the results were. All right, I hope you found this helpful. If so, please like the video and subscribe to the channel for more. Thanks for watching.